It's my first time visiting Ron's home, the burrow. The burrow is several stories high, and is so crooked it looked as though it was held up by magic. Ron thinks that his home isn't much. I think it's wonderful, a magical house. What more can a person ask for? Ron's parents consider me part of their family, and ask me to visit the burrow as often as I like. The Dursleys wouldn't have liked it. There were plenty of weeds and grass that needed cutting. There is a large overgrown garden, which is home to several gnomes. Ron had to regularly de-gnome the garden by throwing them out. But the gnomes always sneak back in. Speaking of Ron's dad, he's like a father I never had. Arthur entrusted me with sensitive information, even when Ron's mom felt I was too young to understand. We frequently talk about Muggle devices. Arthur is fascinated with all things Muggle made. He is always carefree and happy. The only time Ron has seen him losing his cool is when Ron's older brothers, Fred and George, tried to trick him into making an unbreakable vow. An unbreakable vow is a type of binding magical contract, and if broken, it would result in the imminent death of the person who broke the contract. No wonder Arthur was mad. Fred's left buttock has never been the same since. Arthur wants to bewitch a Muggle car to fly. I hope he succeeds. It would be nice to take the flying car to Hogwarts. Ron's brother Fred has a magical map that revealed every inch and corner of Hogwarts. I wonder if the map really exists. We could take the car and fly around the grounds. Maybe Hermione can make us a batch of Polyjuice potions so that we can change into other people to avoid getting caught. The map was created by Professor Lupin, my father, and my godfather Sirius when they attended Hogwarts. They used the homunculus charm to track the movements of every person in the mapped area. This is advanced magic. I'm not surprised though. My dad was great. I want to be like him when I grow up. Thank you.